viewer. Row definitions. Typically, this is where you will link to the chart of accounts. The description column is what you want to see on your financial statements. You can use appropriate fonts, bolds, and indents to make the description appear as you want to see it. Link to your GP via the financial dimensions column. If you want to display a credit balance as a positive, put a C in the normal balance column. Column definition. Typically, this is where you will link to the time period for the report. The column format has to have a DESC column, or description column. This is where the descriptions from the row format will display. Use appropriate fonts, bolds, and indents to make the data appear as you want it to appear. A column type FD indicates that you want GP data in this column. Use period covered to identify if you want a month-to-date or year-to-date column. Tree definition. Trees allow data to be separated by segments within the chart of accounts and or different companies within GP. Link to the company that you wish to add to the tree. Name this branch of the tree. Enter the dimensional link to the chart of accounts. The Reports tab. This is where the action is. This is where you're going to bring together the row, the column, and if you wish, tree definitions. This is where you'll select the reporting period, and you will select the detail level and provisional settings. The report screen is separated into four tabs. The second tab, the output and distribution, is where you indicate where to store the report. If you choose to export your report to Excel, this is where you determine how Excel receives the report. The third tab, the headers and footers tab, is where the titles of the reports go. Insert auto text to determine what values you want to display on the report. The final tab is the settings tab. This is where you can set things like rounding, how to display negative numbers, and how to display a zero. Now that all the report options have been selected, it is time to determine which viewer or browser to use to view the report. The web viewer is the default viewer to access Management Reporter reports. Since the reports open in a web browser, no additional software needs to be installed. Use the report browser to add a comment to a row, download the report to Excel. If a chart was added via the report viewer, it can be accessed via the fact pane. Use the go to skip to different report sections. View previous versions of the report with the ability to switch back and forth. Use the report viewer to add comments to your report, to add graphs to your report. Export the report to Excel, or select which version of the report you'd like to view. Which to choose? If you add charts to the reports, you have to use the report viewer. If you want the ability to switch report versions and currencies, you have to use the web viewer. Otherwise, the two tools are essentially the same. So how do you switch back and forth? You can switch from the web viewer to the report viewer from the Tools menu by selecting Options. Uncheck or check the Use Management Reporter Report Viewer as Default Viewer checkbox. Time for a demonstration. Let's switch over to Management Reporter to see the rows, the columns, and the trees in action. Logging into Management Reporter, starting with my row definitions. I'll start with my balance sheet. Here you can see we have descriptions that have different fonts, different sizes, bolds, different indents. The link in this case to my financial dimensions is using the account category. The account category can be replaced with or in addition to the account numbers. account departments, or in the case of my Fabricam company, my account divisions. At the bottom of my balance sheet, I'm using total rows to add different rows together. I'm also using the underline and the double underline. And I have my print control for my normal balance, so I can turn negative or credit balances into positive numbers. Moving to the columns, my description column is the first column. This could be in the middle if you were using a month to date and a year to date with lots of variances on an income statement. My second column is a financial dimension column. This links to my general ledger, and in this case I'm pulling the periodic or month to date balance. That will essentially on a balance sheet give me my net change. My third column is year to date. This is where I'm pulling the year to date. And then we have attribute columns. The attribute columns are going to pull the originating record name or the vendor or the customer and the document number. And in case of a journal entry, the journal entry number and the reference. I'll be able to drill on those when I use a drill on the periodic column. Moving to the reporting tree, this is where I can link to my different companies in column A. Column B and C are the unit names and descriptions. These can be placed on the report in the header or the footer. Column D is the link to the GL. So here we see that a no-name department has division 0 and department blank. A no-name department could also be division 0 and department 00. A division can be 000 and department 01. Those all roll together into division 000. The administration, accounting, and sales department don't have such a distinction, so all the departmental codes roll into one line of the division. We could add extra lines and expand those if we wanted to. So let's bring the three elements together into a report. Choosing my row definition, we have our balance sheet. Choosing my column, I select the year-to-date column. And using a reporting tree, my sample tree. At the top, my company name, I can look at any company, and the company tree will then drive which company I look at, or I can name the company I want to pull the data from. My financial level of detail will give me just the report. I can also change that to financial and account, or financial account and transaction. Remember that I can drill on a month-to-date column to get transactions. Obviously, the more data you pull, the longer the report may take to generate. So pulling a transaction-level report in period 12, if you have millions of journal entries, may take a little longer than just pulling a January report that was just financial. Under provisional, you can choose posted activity only, posted and unposted, or just unposted activity. This gives you the ability to do what-if scenarios. You can enter a journal entry, not post it, and then let the system generate the report using that unposted journal entry to see the effect of your unposted journal entry. Select your base period and your base year. Moving on to the output distribution tab, this is where I'm posting my report to my library and indicating what I want to have happen when I export my report to Excel. In my headers footers, I have my report name in the top left, my company description in the top left, I have the number of pages, and my date and time the report was printed. Using the insert auto text, you can insert titles from your reporting tree. You can pull things from your report definition, your row definition, your column definition. You can insert the periods that you're covering from the date time. You can insert your page numbers, and you can pull up to 10 different fields from your reporting tree that gives additional detail about a certain level of reporting tree. Under Other, we can show the rounding precision. We can see our file name, our building block group names, or if you need a blank line. Moving to the Settings tab, we're going to choose if we want to have rounding. If we do choose rounding, we have to decide which order we're going to do the processing. Do you want brackets around your negative numbers? Do you want to display your negative numbers in red? Do you want to have digit separators or commas between the thousands? Do you want to display rows with no amounts? Do you want to display blanks for zeros? If you are choosing a zero, do you want to override that with a word instead? Say nil. In the Other button, this is where we can see our margins, whether we're printing our report in portrait or landscape. We have additional details about transactions and additional options. So our report is ready to generate, but before I do, I'm going to check to see where I'm going to view my report. Am I going to use Management Reporter Viewer as my default, or am I going to look at my web browser? I'm actually going to start with my report viewer as the default and generate. Because I'm using a tree, the system wants to know what levels of the tree I want to report for. I'm going to select every level of the tree and click OK. And now the system will count at me. My report is generated. I can use the tree on the left side to go through the different divisions and departments of data. I can drill because I have a month-to-date column all the way down to the individual transactions that make up that balance. Using the back button, I can go back to the top of that data. I can add a note or a comment to a particular balance. So you're going to say, way to go. This is a great bank balance. When I do that, the report now shows a little yellow sticky note over on the left side, and I can see my comment over on the right side. If I right click and select a row, I can choose to make a chart. If I right click on a column, then I can select that column, and again I can choose to make a chart. So if I make a pie chart off my balance sheet, I can then see what my year-to-date balance sheet looks like as a pie chart. I'm going to go ahead and close that report. I'll go back to the Tools and Options menu and uncheck the box for Management Reporter Viewer so that I get my web viewer back again, and I'll generate the report a second time. So today we've looked at the rows and the columns and trees inside Management Reporter and how they interact to become a report. We've looked at the two report viewing tools that are available in Management Reporter.